Next, I am going to discuss about change of temperature with altitude under adiabatic condition. And all you know what is adiabatic condition. Adiabatic means that means change of heat is constant. That means Q is equal to heat. That means Q equal to constant. So dQ equal to zero. So now in that case, let's consider a packet of air with imaginary boundary that is moving up. Also assume that in that case of air behaves as a ideal nature. So in ideal nature, that means according to first law of thermodynamics, we can write dQ equal to dE plus dW, where dQ equal to change of heat and dE is equal to change of internal energy and dW is the work done. Okay, so now for 1 mole of an ideal gas, all you know that PV equal to RT. Now differentiate PdV plus VdP equal to RdT, and R is the molar gas constant. Okay, so now next we can write PdV equal to RdT minus VdP. From first law of thermodynamics, dQ equal to dE plus dW and dQ equal to CV dT. That means dE equal to CV dT from the definition of molar heat capacity at constant volume. So dQ equal to CV dT plus PdV. Okay, now next putting the value of PdV in this equation, and now dQ equal to CV dT plus RdT minus VdP. Now in that case, dQ equal to dT common CV plus R minus VdP, and from the CP minus CV equal to R. Okay, and now CP is the heat cost, molar heat capacity at constant pressure. So now we can write dQ equal to CP dT minus VdP. Okay, now under adiabatic condition, dQ equal to zero. So now we can write CP dT equal to VdP. Now dT dP equal to V by CP. Now this is the relationship between atmospheric temperature and pressure. Okay, next we would like to find out how atmospheric temperature change with altitude. Now this is the diagram in case of consider a static column of air with cross-sectional area A, capital A, of air placed at a height of L centimeter from base, with thickness dL and density rho, and mass is equal to rho into A into dL due to static air. External and internal pressure must be equal in that case. Now internal pressure, that means PL, is equal to the atmospheric pressure, and which is represented by PL plus DL, and pressure of the slice PDL due to its weight. Okay, so now we can write PL equal to PL plus DL plus PDL. Now what is the definition of pressure? Pressure is equal to force per unit area. So now force is equal to mass into acceleration, that means rho into A into dL into G, by area is A. So from this equation we get rho dlg, and g is the acceleration due to gravity. Okay, next PL equal to PL plus DL plus rho DLG. Okay, now DP means small amount of change of pressure. So P into L plus DL minus PL, and DP is the incremental pressure. Now from this equation, DP equal to minus rho DLG. Okay, so DP DL is equal to rho G. Now DT by DL, then we can write dT dP into dP dL. Okay, now dP by dP is equal to 1. Now in that case, dP is equal to 1. Okay, now value of dT dP is equal to V by CP, and dP dL value is minus rho G. So from this equation, we can write minus V into rho into G by CP, and V into rho is equal to mass and unit mass of gas slice. That means V into rho is equal to 1. So now next dt dl equal to minus g by cp, and negative sign indicate temperature decreases with increasing height or altitude. Okay, now r equal to dt dl. Okay, and r is equal to rate of change of temperature with altitude, and the value of r is equal to 9.76 degrees Celsius per kilometer. Okay.